Right. Oh, McKenna, can you grab the mirror from inside the bathroom? The little handheld, the small one? Just one is good. Thank you so much. Hello. Ray, please. Can I play royalty-free music? Royalty-free music. Royalty-free music classical. Let's do that. Classical public domain. This feels right. Hold
Thank you
on.
for coming on such short notice.
I'm here today to, I'm here today to show you guys something that I find very amusing. It's, I want to do a makeup look. I'm turning this down. I want to do a makeup look with my new BH Cosmetics makeup that I dropped very recently. I know you guys, most of you guys know, some of you may not. If you don't, I released a palette, a few palettes actually. One 36 color palette. This one's not open, but there's more. This one's open. These both are open. No, they're not. Yes, they are. No, they're not. Yes, they are. This one is. So, I'm gonna do a look today before the sun goes down. This is the 36 color palette that I did, and it's very, very colorful, and I'm gonna try. I actually like this music, but in this setting, it's weird for me. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do gymnastics on here today. And when I say gymnastics, I mean I'm gonna play music and pause it every 10 seconds to make sure that I don't get kicked off of live over this. So here we go. Here we go. They do give you a warning if you if they don't want you playing music. They'll be like, "Hey, bitch. Hey, stupid idiot. Don't play this music or else we'll kick you off." And I never listen, but today I'm listening. Today I will fold. I will submit to the laws of instruction. Brushes too. I have a few palettes, so I have just to give you like a short breakdown of what the theme of everything is, I wanted to do something that was geared towards nature, but all the colors of nature. So I know that this looks like a rainbow, like a vomited rainbow, a rainbow that diarrhea, but it's not. I wanted florals and I wanted things that represented like water and vegetation and flowers and shit. So I did that there. But then I also have these quads. Is that quads? Four? When four colors are in one thing? I have quads. Oh, fuck. Quads. And so these are my quads. These are my quadriceps that I have created. I believe it's three of them. One is all the elements, all the minerals, the metals of the earth. Maybe not all, but whatever. Gold, silver, and bronze. So this is the gold palette. So you have four different golds here. And two or three of them are actually shimmer. One is matte, which is like a mustardy kind of gold matte. This is a silver palette. So you have three shimmers here, I believe. Some of them are very like calm shimmers. One is like a more very shimmery shimmer. This is the more shimmery one. But then these are like basically all the little silvery kind of shades. And then I have a bronze. And the bronze is very bronzy and coppery. And they're all quite shimmery, not overtly though. They all have like a subtle sheen. Anyway, which honestly, this can be part of the look that we do today because I wanted to do something that was kind of warm and fall inspired. So let's get to it. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and leave a comment down below. What? Bitch, what the fuck? How did... I'm not doing this today. I'm not. Leave me the fuck alone. Everybody leave me the fuck alone. Fuck right off, for real. Anyway, if you're wondering what that ordeal was just now, don't. So let's start. I'm gonna do my eyes first before my face. And I'm going to start with my brushes are filthy and there's nothing wrong with that. Deal with it. I don't know. If you don't like me, then go. Leave. Get out of here. No, she's... All right, here we go. Not Potch's wife, please. Okay. I really like these colors here. There's one called Fauna, which is actually really, really pretty. And it's like a... It's like a shimmery, kind of rusty, coppery color. And then Mystery seems like a good one too. Mystery is like a brown, warm brown. And then I kind of like Mystic. I might use those. It's quite red. Um, so far, this has been a hot mess. But I'm going to start with the transition shade. And I feel like Dream is a good one. And this is this one right here. That's Dream. So I'll do that with my filthy, disgusting, nasty bacterial brush. Can you guys hear me? Testing, testing. You can hear me? Okay, great. I actually really like this. This one is a very good transition shade. And just looking at it, I honestly wouldn't say that it is, but then until you put it on your skin while you're moisturized, it's really nice and kind of peachy. I'm fucking with it. Okay, and then I want this to be more wearable, so I might not go too fall, like too, I don't want this to be too costumey, so I might avoid the orange and just go for anything that's really more like neutral, more bronzy, more chill today. We can do something fun. Oh, you know what? Oh, that's kind of cute. Wait a minute. I kind of like that on the inside here. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. And then I'm gonna start shaping my eye with Mystery, because I feel like that's a nice shade, which is this dark brown here. It's a matte brown, so you can really carve out a shape for your eye. But I feel like, yeah, this look will still look really nice for like fall. Oh fuck, I need a charger. Let me see if this is working. This is, I mean, it doesn't, it's not fully broken. It kind of, There's a fun trick that I do so that I can start my nose contour. I'm not going to do it just yet. I'm going to do it later. But I bring this in just a little bit, the shadow that I'm using out here, to kind of keep with that shape so that when I go to do that, I can blend it into something. So it's not just like it's going up into here. I'm going to take whatever I'm contouring my nose with into this area a little bit. But yeah, you get it. And then
je vais te Yes, I have a cold. And then, what is it? What is it? I really like, I think I want to go for a mostly, I like this one here because it's kind of champagne-y and it'll make your eyes pop out, but I don't know if I want to go darker because I would either do that or this. And these are really pretty. I'm really not sure. I think it could be nice to take the coppery color and kind of, honestly, I think that's fine. I love that. Oh, that's really pretty. Okay, so then let's do that. So I'm taking Fauna. And this is Fauna, right here. That's Fauna. And I'm just placing it over my lid. With a fluffy blending brush. Because I don't know why. Deal with it. No one cares. I like that. Whatever. And then I'm gonna take my finger and use Dynasty, which is that other color that I like, which was right next to Fauna. I'm gonna take Dynasty and I'm gonna put it right while simultaneously flipping everyone off. I'm gonna just place it right in the middle of my lid. And does this make things look muddy? Maybe, who knows? I think it looks great. And then I'm gonna blend it out with a clean brush, which I don't have, so whatever. And just over the center. Not all over, just the center. Oh, I have clean brushes. So just over the center. Like that. And then, I'm going to blend out any extra shit. I need to darken this more. Add some orange, fuck it. This is gonna be a nightmare. I'm scared to work with colors. I told a lot of the interviews that I had about this makeup line is that I have trouble working with color, like colored eyeshadow. So like pinks and The thing is, I have a pink smoky eye that I really fucking like that I did like every day months ago, but I don't know. I don't know why I'm so scared of like blue and like green and orange. And I can do it. I've done it before, but like I just, because I know if I fuck up, I have to start over again. Fuck it. Let's fuck up and start over again. Oh, I have clean brushes. Look at this. So I'm gonna go in with Mystic and pray to God as I do it in my head. And I'm gonna use that as kind of like the outer shade, sort of in between the transition shade and the deeper brown color. God help us all. I'm converting. I can't do this. I can't. Someone help me. Oh! You know, it's not the end of the world. It's really not that bad. Anywho, I'm gonna start doing my, this isn't it, this can't be it, this can't be over, this can't be the last thing. What about this palette? What did I say about this? They're all shimmers. So I'm gonna go back in with this dark matte brown. I'm going to recarve out my, still need to do liner, still need to. I like it. I'm really not even. I'm not mad at it. Whatever, let's start doing face. Thank you. this orange stuff all over my mouth is, it's for aesthetic purposes. Just kidding. It's a color corrector. So I'm very green around my mouth, and that helps get rid of that green tone. It cancels out the green. And not shitting you at all, this is my favorite thing to use for foundation. This brush fucking rocks my socks. And it's very good for, like, if you want a more natural thing, I would say. But it dries it fast enough for it to kind of, like, when you use a sponge, you're putting on more product. When you use a brush, that's just the truth. And if you don't think that, then leave, get out. But this brush is really good for, like, not overdoing it. And that's why this is my favorite foundation brush of all time. I still use a sponge, but I use that to kind of, like, suck the product off of my face sometimes. Or blend out little parts. But this is really top notch. This is really that motherfucker. This is really that mother goddamn fucker. So, oh, also the anal bead thing. Let's talk about it. My brushes are not anal beads, but if you would like them to be, fine. No one's stopping you. Live your best of lives, and be your true authentic self. That's what I would say about that. You want to put a brush in your ass, go for it. You know, you want to put a broom in your ass, go for it. It's meant for cleaning the house, but fine. Like, don't do it. Like, maybe you might get splinters. I don't know. Don't do it. Like, I didn't say do it, but I did say, like, be your true authentic self. Like, no one's stopping you. Yeah. Also, another thing is I love using these blending brushes for a lot of different things. One of them is concealer, because in the same way that the other one is this kind of fluffy-ish, flat top brush is good for foundation, this is also very good for concealer because it just keeps it really seamless. I love it so much. So definitely, if you are buying these brushes, try this one out with your concealer. And I recommend using it with like a more wet, creamy, kind of juicy concealer. And I just put it in there, and I can draw on. I just used concealer on this brush, so maybe not if you're using a dirty ass brush, but I take my finger then, never mind. Completely undo what you heard from me just now. Whatever I said does not matter anymore. But, well, I mean, the point was really that you can use these brushes for anything. They're very versatile. As all brushes are, to be honest. Doesn't matter. My collab or not, you know. You can use brushes for anything. But this is where this guy comes in. I love to use this beauty blender for the contour parts. Because it's just quicker, and it makes me very, very happy. So shout out to that over there. Reckon with Dream. Since I did my concealer and everything, blah blah blah, not done with the face, so don't judge me, but I'm doing my transition shade under my eye with kind of a rounded detail brush. I'm just gonna kind of do that right at the bottom, not necessarily even at the lash line, because I want this to kind of help fade out the darker color I'm about to go in with. If that makes any sense. I'm just gonna kind of bring it out as well. And then do this here as well. And then I'm gonna go with the mystery color, the dark brown that's in my crease. I'm just gonna go with the same brush right against the lash line with that. And connect it to that outer part over here. Rare. Q-tip for this, but just so that there's some color in this, I'm gonna lick a Q-tip with my nasty, disgusting tongue. I'm gonna dip it in this color called Lair, and it's a icy, shimmery blue. And I'm gonna put that right in the center. So I feel like that'll make it kind of fun. McKenna, can I use your flashlight for a second? And you can see there's like a nice like light bulb of blue. Right in the middle. I'm gonna do that on the other side. I actually kind of like that. That made me excited. So I'm going to use this brush again. And kind of feather it out more so it's more seamless. Thank you. Okay. So then, can I see that blush palette right there on the top? Yeah, that one. And then what are those? These look like these are highlighters. This is loose powder and highlighter. So this is a loose highlighter. I'm gonna use this last, but I'm gonna do blush now. These are my blush palettes. So you have sort of the more like pinkyish peach colors. And then if you wanna go for something that's more bronzy and more summery, or honestly something for fall, these all work too. You have this really bright orange, which is fun for like editorial or just putting a little bit more warmth into stuff. You can kind of create like a coral shade with this middle pink and this orange, which might be fun. I can try that, and I will. And I'm gonna use this brush. There's no name for it. It's just this one. That's it, that's all. It's just this. That's all it is. It's this. So first, I guess I'm gonna go with this more natural peachy pink, which is the bottom shade right there. I'm just gonna place that in this general area just to give myself some color. And over the nose. And then I'm gonna use this hot ass pink in the middle, which is extremely fucking pigmented. Be careful, because I just scrubbed the shit out of it with all of my might, and that was a big mistake. And then I'm gonna use a little bit of this orange with it as well. That is also very pigmented. And I'm gonna use both of these shades to kind of create fun little C shape. And depending on what your undertones are, this can look really good. And you can edit and kind of create your own blush color with these. I know when you look at them, they're so starkly bright, like this is very orange, and you're thinking, well, how the fuck do I wear that? But it's not about going heavy with it, it's about going really, really light and building up to where you wanna be. Because that's very pink, that middle color, and that's very orange. You can blend these two together to make anything. You could mix the orange with this peachy shade, and these two would be beautiful together. I think they're very left for your interpretation, if that's the right way to put it. I don't know, whatever. But I do love how this orange looks. And I think this orange with this blue on the inside, they're complementing each other really well. So bada bing. And then I'm gonna put on a lash, and that's it. And eyebrows. I need eyebrows and contour. Hold on. liquid lipstick. Let me see all the lip stuff. Yeah. So, oh, look. Yeah. I need to do lashes and highlight, and then I'm done. I'm using the champagne highlight. I'm going right with this highlighter brush right on the highs of my cheeks. And down the center of the nose. A little bit on the forehead and the chin. Fuck, my back hurts like a motherfucker. Okay, and then I don't have lashes, but you get the idea. Voila. Is there a mascara in there? Look at that. Wow, look at God. So this is the Blooming mascara. It's good, and I like it. Is there another mascara in there? This is the only one. Okay, cool. And it's good. And it's honestly better for your lower lashes. There is no mascara for upper lashes. This is a bottom lash mascara, unfortunately, but we make do with what we have and we're grateful. Let me see that. What is that? This is eyeliner?
Yeah.
Cool. So, yeah, And then I would hit my bottom lashes with this. Again, what the fuck is that? What the fuck is that? Whatever. Anyway, I'm doing this shit on my bottom lashes. What's that? Is that the same thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, fucking kill me. You know what it is. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And, that's pretty much it. I hope you like my eyeshadow look. All right. Go buy my collection. Bye.